welcome one and all to a very special edition of the ATS News. I'm Johnny Anonymous, and in this episode, we're going to look back at a few notable threads, subjects, and items from the year 2009. So what do you say we get started with this year in review from the number one conspiracy website in the world, AboveTopSecret.com. You know, as we reviewed the threads and presentations from 2009, we soon realized that this was going to be quite an undertaking for our staff. And I would just like to point out that the sheer number of well-presented threads and posts were too numerous to do them all justice. So we've attempted to narrow these down to the ones that garnered a lot of attention from not only our staff, but also from you, the membership of AboveTopSecret.com. These are just a few of those threads, along with a brief summary of each of them, and we're going to begin with a thread entitled Independent Investigation into Pentagon Attack Yields Alarming Information. Now, Burns the Ships presents to us that after a three-year independent investigation into the 9/11 attack, the results lead one to believe that it was not an attack by suicide hijackers, but rather a military Black Ops project. ATS member Zorgon created a presentation entitled Navy Space Command Uncovered. Now, in it, he outlines what appears to be material that may support the theory that there does indeed exist a secret astronaut program. We also find out that HARP may even fall under the command of the Navy. In another thread entitled AP Headline from 2004, Kenyan-born Obama, which was authored by Scooby-Doo, who just happened to find a East African newspaper article from 2004, which claims that President Obama was born in Kenya. This, of course, fueled a number of replies from both sides of the coin by our membership. In a patent found by All-Seeing Eye, turned out to be the source of discussion in a thread entitled Chemtrails, U.S. Patent 5003186, Stratospheric Wells Backseating for Reduction of Global Warming. Now, in this, the debate, of course, over the use of aerosols distributed by jets created quite the frenzy in this thread. Andre18 created an interesting thread entitled Evolution, It's Only a Theory. And in it, he attempts to describe how evolution is both a theory and a fact. And he cites, for example, the theory of gravity, which is not only a theory, but is also a scientific law. Dimensional Detective, in a thread entitled Rockefeller Internet is Number One National Hazard, presents to us the comments by the Rockefeller family who make this claim that, yes, indeed, the Internet is the number one national security hazard. Now, according to him, he wants to know, is this just more fear-mongering by those that would like to quell the independent spirit and freedom of speech and the possible attempt to control the masses? For currency traders like myself, the thread by Red Hattie entitled Red Alert, FX Dislocation in Process certainly was interesting as someone in Asia was buying up a massive amount of dollars and all other currencies were getting pounded. Now, normally the foreign exchange currency market will fluctuate due to any number of geopolitical incidences, but this does appear to have been something else that was influencing the market with the buying up of all these U.S. dollars. Member X Too Strong X brought to our attention that the CIA had once used a Lithuanian horseback riding academy as a torture prison in a thread entitled Exclusive, CIA Secret Torture Prison Found at Fancy Horseback Riding Academy. Now, in documents that were provided by Lithuanian officials, supposedly the CIA purchased the horse stables and performed various forms of torture on Al-Qaeda terrorist. In a collaborative effort by Sky Floating and The Way I See It, a interesting presentation was presented entitled Aliens of Ancient China. Now, some of the topics that are discussed in this thread included the similarities of China's only stone pyramid in a town that just happens to have a similar name as the Egyptian builder of the Pyramid of Giza. And also another topic was the 5,000-year-old iron pipes that seem to predate smelting methods by several thousand years. And what of China's first emperor, Huang Di? Is there any truth to the fact that he possibly was an extraterrestrial? Inspired by Tesla's birthday, member Serbista created the thread Tesla, the Forgotten Mysteries, a great introduction for anyone interested in the genius that was dubbed the Mad Scientist. Conjecture and theories abound surrounding his inventions, patents, and research papers that all were mysteriously confiscated and suppressed by the government following his death. With over 2,500 replies and a slew of other threads created on the subject, the thread by Helmet entitled Spectacular Phenomena in the Sky, What Is It? Fueled speculation, theories, and conjecture on what indeed created the Norway Spiral. And despite the official word that this was a failed missile launch by the Russians, this phenomena struck a chord in many members, and they dove into a frenzy with a number of interesting and very well-presented theories. What You Know brought to us the thread President Obama has won the 2009 Nobel Peace Prize. Many of us were just as surprised as much as the president was that he was receiving this award. The official reason for the award was because of the president being the first African-American to hold the country's highest office and for his calling for disarmament and working on the restarting of the stalled Middle East peace process. In a thread created by Mr. Old School called The Government's Plan to Kill Independent Websites, it is suggested that the enemy of free expression, padded with the deep pockets of big media and telecommunications, have been planning to craft legislation designed to snuff out the independent voices on the Internet. Now, why would they do this, you ask? Well, it's quite simple. According to Mr. Old School, they wish to shift the power of free expression back into the hands of big media conglomerates. The swine flu was a particularly well-discussed event in 2009, and many threads were created by the membership on the subject. A number of these have ongoing updates, and it was decided that it might be well to condense the area for easier reading, and so a new forum was created entitled Swine Flu and Other Diseases and Pandemics. It is in here where you'll now be able to get the latest updates on the swine flu. And these are just a few of the notable threads that were presented in 2009, and we hope that you'll go by and check them out.